and then you had to ask me if I want to fuck her in front of her brother.
At a show in South Bend, I was welcoming people, and a group that was coming in the door was being kind of loud.
By the way, as you guys are coming in, if you could be a little quieter, because you're late. So, the reason I'm doing this tour is because I'm working on new material for a special. So if you've seen my set before, you're not going to recognize anything you've seen before. Seriously, at the door, please. Thank you. They have no idea I'm tired of them. Cool. All right.
They were also chatty when they sat down, so I tried to address it without actually addressing it.
If you do want to participate, you will have ample opportunity to do that. At the end of the show, there will be a Q&A. So until then, I just ask for your love, your support, your respect, because the better you are, the better we are, and that's how the show is going to work.
You can even hear them talking over me, talking about them. As I brought up Radu Bhandar, I leaned in and I said, well, they can't all be great. Then one of them yelled at Radu.
And you don't have to know anything about Romania. You don't have to know anything. Ever, actually. Did you say Slav? Like, my ethnic background? What a weird thing to yell. Imagine I'm a Nigerian comedian. I'm from Nigeria, and someone's like, black! Black! It's the equivalent of what you just did, man.
I was doing a bit about the text of a sign my mother put up while we were kids.
She didn't buy that sign. She wasn't repeating, stop talking. Repeat it. That's part of the fucking job. How amateur do you think I am? That I'm like, I'm just gonna say something quickly and then never address it again. How are you guys doing? Fucking relax. How impatient are you as a person? Just the idea, like she just turns on the first season of Game of Thrones, she goes, who's gonna be king? And then, I can't watch till I know. Turns out, fucking no one. It's a shit end. Anyway, so. Give it a minute. All right. So the sign, I'm not gonna repeat the words that were on it. Fuck, I have to. I want to not, to punish her, but I have to or the joke doesn't work, so.
This woman was not someone who is capable of being embarrassed, so I did my best to just ignore her. Here's a few times she was just drunkenly wooing for no reason.
The word shoot was spelled correctly. If you want to pick up the t-shirt,
I eventually got through the set, and I was talking about my albums.
I have 6 different comedy albums. They're all material you did not hear tonight. They're all different from each other. If you want to pick up one, normally they're $10 a piece, but on this tour, I'm doing all 6 for $25. Now the reason I do that is if you want to say, hey Steve, I support what you do, here's $25, the least I can do is give you 5.5 hours entertainment. Or, if you got a really slow friend, that could be like 30 hours entertainment.
Or like one slow friend.
Or like one slow friend. Yes. Why are you pointing to someone else? So. Your slow friend knew not to interrupt. So if you want to pick up the free stuff, all I ask is you sign up for my email list. That way you can find it the next time. I'm going to be in South Bend if I'm ever passing through on my way to die in the wilderness. I don't know what's near here, but you sign up for the email list or the text list. Please shut up for the text list. That's the nicest I'll be from here on out.
And then, during the Q&A,
do you have any conspiracy theories? No. No. I think that people don't know how to keep their mouths shut. And like, that's what's wrong with conspiracy theory. Because conspiracy theory is based on a whole bunch of people keeping secrets. People can't keep their mouths shut. You saw what happened. We couldn't even get through a show with people keeping their mouths shut. You think we had a conspiracy theory? You think the moon landing was faked and no one's gonna be like, get this shit? Like, no.
I'm glad to be here in Stockton, because I'm indoors. It's the safest way to be in Stockton. I've never had a place before when I put it up on my calendar. So many different people were like, you going to Stockton? Are you going to be all right? Yeah, I'll be fine. I'll be okay. They're like, no, man, everybody there gets murdered. I'm like, they would be into that. you're not gonna listen, stop it. I'm like, I grew up in New York City in the 80s, fuck off, okay? I think I'll be all right. And then I got to Stockton, I'm like, maybe I was not.
But as I went on, a couple to my right started getting a little cozy, and then a lot cozy, and then a fucking ridiculous amount of cozy. It was a small place to begin with. The bar only sat about 50 people, and I thought it was the perfect spot to run my new set. But two people thought it was the perfect spot for other things also. Look, I get it. The current set I'm doing is extremely sexy. I mean, there's nothing that is a bigger turn-on than a stranger talking about growing up in a mixed family, getting bullied, and then eventually getting to material about losing his father. I'm getting turned on just thinking about it. But maybe, just maybe, wait until you get home. Or at least until you get to your car. Especially when it comes to putting your hand in inappropriate places while sitting in the front damn row. I kept looking over at them to try to shake them out of their ridiculously amorous haze. I tried to ignore it as best I could, but when someone interrupted a story about my father and the woman and the couple yelled out, I couldn't ignore it anymore.
What'd he say? My dad said nothing, he's dead, but as it turns out, we don't talk anymore, but... You guys are a weird bunch, I'll tell you.
Yes, you are.
Alright, we're coming out to the crowd participation in a second, so hold off for a second. I appreciate that. Love you back, but we're gonna do it silently. So, we're gonna love each other like we have a roommate in college, just as quiet as possible, so... Just touch the nerve for some people. Anyway, you guys are going at it in front of fucking row. That's weird. So I didn't realize that talking about my bully was like, ooh, that's hot. That's cool. All right, I'm just gonna. I say Stockton's weird. You get mad, and then you make out in front of row. Then maybe I'm not wrong. So. Here's the deal. If you want to, like, don't pick up a copy of the book, that'd be great, but I've gotten some very weird questions about the book. I think the two weirdest questions I got, someone asked me, so, you guys have no idea you paid for two shows, so. My sister.
Yeah.
I have a sister named You know what she's never done in public? Well, man, Stockton, it's really good to be here. And this room, of all rooms, the whole fucking room is the front row. I appreciate that, but it looks like you loves him a little more. So. But the thing is, so you were the one who said hi to me over there, right? And you told me that you very specifically did not watch anything of mine online because you didn't want it to be spoiled. And now that I see you making out in the front row, I believe that you did not watch anything. And I talk about it in the book a little bit, and someone asked me,
Someone asked if, I'm just laughing because he, oh my god, I'm sorry, I just realized.
Usually, the cameras are only pointed toward the stage, and because the room is so small this way, the third one is there. Okay. I'm gonna have to check that shot after the show and see if it's legal. So. You know what, I almost didn't turn that one on. That's why I paused for a second when Nick called me up here, and it took me a second. It was because I was like, oh, I forgot to turn that camera on. And so then I did. And ooh boy, YouTube is going to mark this one not safe for work. So, I got less in high school than that guy did tonight. So, anyway, watch your hands. Anyway, you guys are 47 people with the energy of like 48. Although it's possible he got her pregnant during the show. So that felt the kick from here. Anyway, so this is so gross.
And then during the Q&A,
has a question. That's cool. Who else has a question? Craziest after show experience I've ever had. I don't know, but I have a feeling it's gonna be topped.
I'm gonna pick up any of those. That'd be absolutely awesome. So now that that's said,
are they $20?
What?
Are they $20?
No.
How much are they?
What?
The shirts.
I know what you mean. I'm just, it's a weird time to haggle. They're $25. Okay, so.
So who's the winner here?
So who's the winner?
If I buy a shirt, you are.
If you buy a shirt, okay. This is, you guys really held out as long as you possibly could to like interrupt. You're like, oh thank God, it's been 40 minutes where I couldn't talk. Holy shit.
People have to pee.
What?
People have to pee.
People have to pee. Then pee.
I did.
I don't mean right now. I mean please leave and come back. Okay, do you have to talk while you pee? Are you just like, come on, little fella?
I'm not peeing right now. I already peed. I just want to know about the shirts.
What?
I said I'm not peeing right now. I just want to know about the shirts.
I want to know about the shirts. So what did people having to pee have to... Do you need it to mop up the pee? What is happening? This is the... I like peanut butter. Do you swim? Anyway, so... that was a very supportive, like, I feel like she genuinely wants to buy a shirt, she just doesn't know how transactions work. Like, it's just a very, like, it's, okay, after the show, I will stand outside there. You may come and go and pee as you please.
Do you take debit cards? Yes,
but only if you wash your hands first. So, shit, dude. You know, I was like, why haven't I been here in 11 years? And then you guys were like, we'll remind you. Okay, so this is the weirdest. Do you want to buy the shirt right now at this moment?
If you'll take my debit card.
No,
hold on.
Everyone,
you think I don't know what the fuck I'm doing? Seriously, here. Here, come give me the debit card right now. I'll take the debit card right now.
I'm getting it.
Okay.
That's a T-shirt.
That had to be Radu. That had to be Radu in the back. Okay, so you have the debit card? Thank you so much. Go have a seat. So you'll get that back later, or maybe you won't. We'll find out. So, how many people want a shirt? She's buying. So, although it's a debit card, she's buying like four. So,
then during the Q&A, someone asked me about the first five times I did stand up.
Offhand, my fifth did not stand out to me. My third time was the worst show I've ever done.
My third time I remember very well, because my... I'm fucking getting to the story. Is that the same person the whole time? Okay, I'm just making sure, because there might be a couple of people with that voice. I don't know how many of you have minivans, but...
Someone else asked a serious question.
What do you got?
Wait, no.
I'm not going to let you clarify that far back. Jesus Christ.
When I went and saw Richard Pryor,
yeah.
He was heckled by the Black Panther.
Okay.
I saw George Carlin.
Wait, hold on. I'm going to interrupt you because we don't have enough time to go through the whole thing. I know what the question is. What is the line of social responsibility for a comedian? And I know the question because that's what you said.
And
you've studied Lenny Bruce. Okay. None of that has to do with anything that's happening today. That's why I cut you off. Because, holy shit. Can I use your debit card to buy you crutches? So. No. I know what you're talking about. The reason I say, I know what you're saying. And I don't mean to be rude. I'm cutting you off just for the sake of time because we have to end soon. So. The reason I say it has nothing to do with today is because the way that we treated people who were different than us in the 60s and the 70s and the 80s, fuck even last year, is different than what we do today. So the line of social responsibility as a comedian is the same as the line of social responsibility as a human being that has other people listening to them. It's as simple as that. And the comedians who will make the argument of like, whatever, it's just a joke, be like, okay, would you say it off stage? Will you make it as an argument? No, then it's not just a joke, it's words that you're saying. So the line of social responsibility is to do things like, for instance, I think it's socially responsible for people to be able to hold their alcohol in public. So, which is why I'm teaching a fucking lesson. Anyway, so.
To lighten it up, here's a question about me having a black sister.
One more, what do you got?
How often do you use your sister to fuck black chicks?
How often do I use my sister to fuck black chicks? Never. Like, how would that even work? Do you mean, like, introduce her? Or do you mean, like, I walk up to a black person and I'm just like, you know, as it turns out, I know a little something about how to do your hair. Like, is that... You know, if I fuck up your hair, I can fix it in the morning. Like, is that the pickup line?
And I closed with this.
The reason you were able to have fun on Tuesday night is because the staff was working on Tuesday night. So what I ask you to do is take one more dollar out of your wallet or your purse or your money clip if you're a dick bag, just however you carry around. One more dollar and put it down on your table, because if you do that, it will not change your night at all. But if we all do that, it will absolutely change theirs. So let's do that for them. And if I could just lead by example and just... Thoughts on what? Thoughts on Donald Trump. I think I made it pretty clear with my earlier joke, but my thoughts on Donald Trump are interesting. Okay, I'll tell you this. It's interesting to see the difference in our political systems, by the way. Because, like, you guys have a prime minister, and obviously we don't. We have a drunken monkey in a space helmet. But... So take the prime minister. Oh, okay, you'd rather Donald Trump? One for one trade, let's do it! We'll throw in a politician to be named later. And it'll be fucking Pauline Hanson from Australia. And here's the thing. I know that some of you guys don't like Trudeau because there are people in Edmonton that want to secede, which is fucking amazing to me. I saw that billboard today. They want Alberta and Saskatchewan to secede and become its own country with two cities. What do you mean, what? There's a fucking billboard in your city. I did not make this up. I'm not from here and I know this. But you know everything about your politics. Anyway, so... There's a secessionist movement for fucking two provinces. Like you guys are going to be your own country and be like, well, we have a mall. We'll do fine. It's fucking ridiculous. And here's the thing. Look, Trudeau ain't perfect, all right?
But your last guy, motherfucker, that was George Bush, but colder. Like, Trudeau, he's trying. I know he's trying. He fucks up, but he's trying. When you guys elected Trudeau, here's what happened. Let me fucking finish. Here's what happened. I already know you disagreed with me. I'm responding to what you said disagreeing. You don't have to disagree with me a second time. Let me fucking finish. Okay, so my point is that you guys elected Trudeau, and when you did, you guys were like, okay, look.
Who fucking elected Trudeau?
Canadians.
Okay, how many in this fucking room? How many in this fucking room?
Are you, hold on a second, sir. Sir, when I said you guys, were you confused at what I meant? No, I just want to know. When I said you guys, did you think that I meant only you guys specifically? Do you think I don't understand your politics so much? Yeah, Canadians did. As Canadians, do you know how voting works? I don't think he does. Okay. You voted for someone else. Did that person get more votes than Trudeau?
No.
No, then Canadians elected Trudeau. I get it, you want to make Canada great again, I get it, but... Okay, you didn't vote for him. Now we all know that, and we can't judge you for voting for him. Is that what you were worried about? That a bunch of strangers in this room might be like, that guy over there voted for Trudeau. I mean, I heard the comedian say, you guys, he must have meant 100% of us. And therefore, now I know you why you don't like an intellectual prime minister. I don't want to vote for this guy. He's a reader. I think you may have picked the wrong comic, sir.
He doesn't know.
It's all good. I appreciate it. I mean, my act is, but... I appreciate it. It's all good. Don't worry. We're all... here. What? What about Trump?
You're better off than Trump.
That was what you interrupted me to disagree about. I was literally saying you guys elected Trudeau instead of Trump. You're like, not fucking us! It's better than Trump! I think maybe we need tests before people vote. This is your fucking fault. You asked that question. I wish you very luck in the country of very good luck in the country of Alberta Shawan. Saskatchewan. Northern Kansas. No. Okay. How do we fucking wrap this up after that?
My first set ever as a comedian, and do I have any advice for amateur comedians? My first set ever actually went pretty well, because I worked on it a lot. And then my second set went okay, because I didn't do so well, but then I made fun of myself not doing well, and that got laughs. And so I thought, oh, if I just fail, I'll just make fun of it, and then I'll succeed. And I told another comedian, I said, oh, I guess I can't bomb. And the universe heard me. And the universe smote me. And my third show, I still have nightmares about that fucking show. I was hosting, I did a minute before I knew I had to leave. It was actually less than a minute. I was opening up, and in less than a minute, I got the fuck off stage. You know how bad that has to be for you to leave after less than a minute? I know exactly how bad that has to be. My advice for you, are you an aspiring comedian? Excellent. How many times have you been going on stage a bunch? That means no. That was the kind of that would get you arrested if you were being asked about drugs. Do you have any drugs? No. to jail. So back home. So you did stand up back home? Where is back home? I've probably never heard of it. Oh, I'm sorry. Do you think I'm dumb? I'm a traveling comedian. You think I've never heard of Newfie? I know what Newfie is. And and Labrador, I like it just because it's a dog's name. If you guys had a province named Staffordshire Bull Terrier, I'd hang out there all the time. I've heard of a lot of places. I even know how to pronounce Regina. It's hilarious, but I know how to pronounce it. It's spelled Regina, but it's Regina. I learned that. I don't know how the fuck. Well, how the fuck did they do that? Where they're like, oh, you know what? We're gonna spell it Regina, but we're gonna pronounce it hilarious. First time I heard of it, I was in Vancouver, and I was talking to a guy, and I was like, where are you from, man? And he said, I'm from Regina. I said, aren't we all? So, I don't mean to be combative, but I have heard of Newfoundland, and I know even how to say it, even though on the map it looks like Newfoundland. And they're like, no, it's Newfoundland, because we pronounce words as quickly as possible there. So you're from Newfoundland and Labrador. Professional actor slash criminal lawyer back there. Oh yeah, I think I've seen your billboards. Okay, so back there, so you moved here now.
Putting my songs to the comedian on stage.
20 times in a year and 4 months. So, if I were to hazard a guess, that is about every 3 weeks. Yeah, that's because I'm not stupid. So, every 3 weeks you do one show. My advice? Stop it. Or fucking do it. But you can't be a criminal lawyer slash actress. You do fucking your thing. You do your thing. Pull out the safety net and fucking go. Do you want to be a stand-up comedian?
I do.
You do. Excellent. When's the next time you're going on stage?
Next Wednesday.
Next Wednesday. You just plugged a different comedy club? You know, we're all gonna hire a different lawyer. I object. So, I wish you luck. Don't plug another comedy club. Yeah, you just said, you just yelled out to the owner, I love you. It's a weird way to show it. Alright. Anyway, no, but I truly do wish you luck, and I've written a ton of advice columns for a website called comedyhints.com, so if you want to read through those, that's where all my advice for an up-and-coming comic would be. And I truly do wish you a great deal of luck, and when I come here next year, I want to hear that you went on stage 4 times every single fucking week. Okay? Next. Yeah. Even if you're lying, just pretend. So, you know how to lie, you're a lawyer. Anyway, so, I'll do one more question, we'll get out of here. What do you got?
Do you still get nervous, or did you ever get nervous?
Do I still get nervous, or did I ever get nervous? I absolutely used to get nervous. I used to get nervous a great deal, because when I first started, you know, comedy wasn't my full-time gig, I was also a defense lawyer, and I got both nervous and defensive, and so.
And in Portland.
What do you got right there?
Do I have any advice for comedians who live out of their cars doing open mics? Yes. Move somewhere cheaper. A parking space in Portland costs what a house does in Indiana. Fucking move. But if I'm in Portland, I get to be within striking distance of 2 other cities. Tough place to start. No, but for real, you know, just do your own thing. Put stuff up, you know? Make a YouTube channel. You'll be successful by 2029. And by then, your car will drive itself, so.
And in Cleveland.
What's the hardest thing about starting stand-up?
What's the hardest thing about starting stand-up?
sucking. Everybody does. That's the hardest thing about starting anything, is that you suck when you start. But the thing is, you start almost anything else, you start that by yourself. Start it by yourself. If you've never worked out before, you're really intimidated, you could pick up a fucking dumbbell at home and start lifting it and get a little bit better. You can't do stand-up to no one. That's not how it works. You have to go perform to people and you're gonna fucking suck. Because that's how it starts. You have to learn how to crawl and then learn how to walk. And most people are like, I'm funny in conversation occasionally. I bet I'll be funny on demand on stage. Fucking no, you won't.
In Eugene, someone asked about my first show. One of the openers was Bert Walpack, an old comedy buddy of mine who quit being a comedian to be a dentist and is now thankfully doing comedy again.
What was your first stand-up performance like?
What was my first stand-up performance like?
What was that experience like?
Bert, you might have been there. We started in New York together. It's been about 15 years since we've seen each other, I think. Yeah, holy shit. Well, you know, he got all successful and became a dentist, and you know, so they don't have time for us. Unless you make an appointment. And then you don't know if it's really funny or if it's just the gas, you know, so it's tough. I should have told them I was Jewish right up front. Why? You'd have been off stage after that one right there. I'm not gonna explore the thought process behind that. Let's just move on. Oregon, home of the KKK. He was like, not us, that's Eastern Oregon. Fuck off. We're near I-5, we're okay, so. That is true, by the way. Oregon is such a weird state because, like, the entire I-5 corridor, I love. It's great. It's awesome. You got, like, a Shakespeare Festival and college towns and, like, fucking weirdos in Portland. It's awesome. And then you go, like, 20 miles east. And then you're just like, where the fuck did everyone go?
Later, someone asked about the Martin Grant, a scholarship I run for up-and-coming comedians, in memory of my father.
What advice would I give comics applying to my scholarship? Fill out the form. And someone asked, because in the form, all you have to do, you put your name, your email, your phone number, and a video. And someone messaged me on Facebook and goes, do you need the video? Like, yes. Actually now, no.
Legalized yet in Ohio?
No.
Only medical. Only medical. And they say you gotta vape it. That is not in the law. Hey, settle down. It is not the law that you must vape. There's no fucking way. I'm gonna fucking look it up. Hold on, I'm gonna look it up or ask any of these other Ohio people. Are you forced to vape in Ohio? Hold on, we'll get there. They suggest you drive vape, but it's not mandatory.
No, they say if you smoke actual straight herb,
it is a crime. Yeah, it's illegal. That's not the same thing. Hold on, that's not the same thing as making you vape it. Yeah, marijuana is illegal in most states. So this got super weird. All right, I think you just own a vape store. And by the way, you just showed it to me. That's just a picture of your kid. That's not... There's no way the Ohio government is like, you can have pot, but only if you chew on a USB stick. There's no way. Holy fuck, this guy's a dealer for sure. So hold on a second. So
3.5% or less is considered hemp.
3.5% or less percent is considered hemp. Hold on, let him fucking talk. Okay, 3.5% THC or less is considered hemp. Okay.
So if you claim that it's hemp, they can't test it in Ohio.
If you claim that it's hemp, they can't test it in Ohio. Right, all the scientists live over the border, so... Hold on a second, here... Hold on. Okay, state law.
That's state law, the state laws.
State laws. Hold on a second. Okay. 30 state. Hold on a second. Talks about Colorado. Colorado, Colorado, Colorado. There will be only 56 dispensaries across the entire state. Hold on a second. I'm finding this. There's no fucking way I'm letting this go. I'm finding this. Hold on. I'm fucking getting there. Let me read. Let me read. Because this is a lot of article that has nothing to do with vaping. Okay, hold on. This big fucking... Hold on. Okay. About cops. About... There's... Hold on a second. That has nothing to do with what you said. Wait, hold on. Also, it's herb. You definitely can't smoke herb. That's illegal. That guy did nothing wrong. Just a nice guy being like, hey, I'm Herb. Stop it, stop it. And he's pure, too. He's just a pure guy named Herb. All right, hold on a second, hold on. Wait. Vapes, edibles, tinctures, and bombs are all acceptable.
But not Herb.
That's not what we were saying. Vaping is one of the ways. That's the whole point. They're all acceptable except... I don't... You're arguing with a thing that you did not say before. You said that you had to vape it. I'm like, there's no fucking way you had to vape it. And they just said there are four different ways you could have it.
You're right. I'm sorry.
I appreciate that. Thank you, man. I appreciate that. I appreciate that. Wait, wait, wait. Sit back down, though. This is... All right. Only thing you can have is herb or other men. Herb is a dude's name. Okay. All right. I am gonna invest in this guy's vape store later. So it's gonna be called You Have to Vape. But it's gonna be the you and the two. It's dope, but I'm not really gonna invest in your vape store, man. I'm not. Okay, this Canton. This got fucking weird. We just put the cant in Canton, so. And now I'm gonna do the on part and move that way. So. All right. Just making a little pot reference, and it went the fuck haywire. But the best part is, if you open a vape store, those people will have their next baby shower at it, so.
When I showed the crowd the tour shirt, this guy started bidding.
This is a tour shirt. I literally only have three of these left, and they're all small, because it's been a hell of a fucking tour. So, it's a free-for-all after the show. Depends on who gets to the table first. So you're adopted too? Okay. Are you also a small? By the way, okay, fuck it. If you guys get a bid like this, the price is gonna go up. Like, if you guys stop showing so much demand, it's bad for the market, guys.
And then during the Q&A, I took a question from the same guy.
All right, man, you're very into the show and very drunk. We'll take your question. What do you got? You're not even that drunk. That is the rally cry of a drunk person, by the way. No one who is not that drunk has ever said they're not that drunk. Hold on, give me a second. I'm doing a bit. No one... I'm explaining. No, because that's true. No one who has ever, like, had a drink or two has been like, I'm really not that drunk. Because no one has ever said to them, this is not a field sobriety test. And if it was, you just lost, motherfucker. All right, just walk that line. And then all the way. Am I selling and signing my book? The thing that I said I was doing before. Yes, I am doing that. Yes, I'm happy to sign it.
Are you booking
it out the back? Am I going to be booking it out the back? No, I've got three people bidding on my shirts. I'm selling the book and the shirts. I'll be there afterward. I will be over in that corner right there. That is where I'll be afterward with breathalyzer and Sam. There's no fucking way you're passing, man. I'm going to download an app on my phone. I'm sure there's an app on my phone. You got Uber, you didn't even drive here.
Well, thank God.
The entire room just went collectively, oh good, we don't have to wait before we leave. because otherwise they were just going to wait for you to leave first. So this, I'm glad you got Uber. It's a safe thing to do. And you just said they all ugly as fuck and you're the only pretty one. You just failed the sobriety test, man. So, all right, just stop it with just, that's, having teeth is not the only qualification. Although maybe it does, I don't know where you came in from. Okay, so.
You folks were really wonderful. It was weird. I truly, make sure he gets an Uber and doesn't just play Angry Birds.
Like, make sure.
We performed in Wichita Falls 2 days before New Year's. There was a guy that yelled out a few times during Brett Druck and Radu Bhandar's set, including yelling 2019. When he yelled during my set, I dealt with it and moved on quickly.
And the guy sits down and he's like a good-looking bro-y dude. And he, a bro-y dude, like the type that would interrupt the joke. And
then, while I was talking about my book, it happened again.
Someone asked me a really shitty question about it once after a show. Just gets real, like, just kind of obnoxious, comes up to me after a show. She just goes, "Is the book inappropriate for high school age children?" And I said, "No, it's a book about my high school experience." And she said, "Was there any sexual content in it?" And I said, "No, it's a book about my high school experience." And by the way, whoever said that they hope there's sexual content about high school children, you might want to learn when to speak and when not to. Just so you know, you're not allowed to fuck teenagers, it's 2019. So. Pretty sure that's been the same guy the whole show.
Brad was talking about selling oatmeal cream pies after the show, and Radu was selling hats that say Cocktown. It's from one of his jokes, it makes sense in context.
We got a tour t-shirt with all the places that I've been, all the times, and all these things, and right here it says Wichita Falls, December 29th. So if you want a souvenir from tonight, I know you have a ton of comedy tour shirts that already say Wichita Falls on them. You'll have to make room. But the proceeds of this actually go to supporting the openers on the tour. So if you enjoyed Brett or Radu, and you don't want a cream pie from Brett, did Radu show you his hats? Did he show you?
No.
No? Radu has hats that say Cocktown on them. Because I saw him do the joke. He did the joke, but I didn't see him do the hats. I just want to know who here is bold enough to walk around Wichita Falls with a hat that says Cocktown. Holy shit, Radu, get more hats. Holy shit.
Yes.
Wait, hold on a second. I want to know what this was. What'd you just say? As long as it says cream pie on the back of the hat that says Cocktown. Are you allowed out generally, or is this? I feel like someone fucked up some paperwork, and that's how this happened.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, it's holiday furlough. So, it's okay. The mayor of Cocktown has said enough. So,
the guy tried yelling again.
I don't know what you said, but it was probably stupid. So.
Then, during the Q&A...
Oh, we got a question over there. What do you got? Am I getting late tonight? Well, no, because I'm not interested in that guy. So, even though it's 2019... What?
But it's 2019!
Yes, that's the thing I said right before you said that. I appreciate that you're almost as quick as me. No, I don't think I'm getting laid tonight. No offense to the stunning population of Wichita Falls. I went on Bumble in Wichita Falls, and Bumble, just, I swiped no on one person, and Bumble was like, "That's it. We just had the one, sorry." Well, you got a question right there. What do you got? What? It's your birthday. That's amazing. That only happens once a year to everyone. You picked you.
What?
Well, does that how it works on dating apps for you also? What's the question? What'd you say? Oh, shit.
Oh, we got mics. We got mics.
Oh, we got mics. Oh, wow. Okay, suddenly I'm on your side. Wait, so is that was the guy who kept talking? Okay, and you're at a table with them and you don't know them. I don't know, I see some people leaving now, I'm not sure if it's the same people. This feels like a prison right now. Radu just got behind me, that's how awkward this is. This is Wichita Falls, goddammit. Half these people are concealed carrying right now. And the other half are open carrying without a license. Correct request. If you are talking and annoying people around you, do shut the fuck up. That would be a nice thing to do. Because you're out in public.
So I tried placating him by taking a question.
What?
I got three separate questions.
No, you got one question. What do you got?
Have you ever met anybody named Trans?
Have I met anyone what?
Have you ever met anybody named Trans?
Anyone named Trans?
Like you're in a
trance.
Yes.
Like you're named Trans?
Like transsexual?
No, so wait, hold on a second. Let me try. This is my fault. Have I met anyone named Trance? I have not met anyone named Trance, because like I said, my parents weren't hippies. And
you know what? Now you have, and mine was...
Now I have. Okay, well, now I know not to do so again. Your birth name is Trance?
Yes.
Your parents named you after how you were conceived? That was meaner than you guys gave it credit for.
You did imply that their parents fucked during hypnosis. So.
I did imply that the only reason that they would fucking have that person is because they were hypnotized.
Hey, well, any credit, you know what? I love doing what I was conceived.
You.
What? You were conceived drinking?
Hold on a second. I just would like to say to the mayor of Wichita Falls. You know, when. No, I'm not waiting for shit. Sit the fuck down, sir. I'm on this one. I'm gonna put. Oh my god, that's horrible. His pickup line is like, can I put a trance in you? That's Yakov Smirnov. In Soviet Russia, they put trance in you!
Everybody take pants off.
Okay. When Brett was up here and he was like, what is going on with this place? And like, a lot of you were like, meth, ha ha! I was in the back being like, ha 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 ha! And then I got up here and I was like, oh shit, they warned us. That wasn't a joke, that was a cry for help. Alright.
Is this on YouTube?
Is this on YouTube? No, this is real life, miss. Alright. One more time for Brett Drunk and Radu Von Bahr. This is a show we're going to be talking about for quite some time.
Yeah!
Because here's the thing, a lot of shows blend together, you do a different show every night, sometimes you forget what happened where. There's no fucking way we're forgetting Wichita Falls. Trance, you should not be clapping. And, this is the last show of the Texas tour. We did 13 cities in Texas. 13 cities in Texas, and we didn't have a heckler the entire time. And I realized that this morning, and I was about to say something to Brett and Radu and be like, hey, we just did 12 different cities in Texas during the holidays and didn't have one interruption at all. And then Wichita Falls was like, I gotcha.
This was in Sydney, Australia. Daniel Muggleton had done a joke about Australia's immigration policy being favorable to white women. I had done a bit about how my parents never made it to Woodstock. And I talked about how the best way to face ignorance is with a sense of humor. I was doing a bit about my sister Sharon, who was adopted and black. One woman couldn't believe that Sharon could possibly be Jewish.
Sharon and I had to sharpen each other, because sometimes people are dumb, sometimes people are ignorant. We were in a synagogue when we were kids, and I know I'm not... Yes, synagogue, it's a place that Jewish people go to. It's... Oh, right, Australia. Jewish people are...
A thing that
sometimes you guys import them to entertain you, and...
Later, I was talking about my other sister, Miriam, and how she danced strangely.
What? Was she white? Yes. It's a different... They have different names. That's how you keep track of them. Here's another question. How would that have changed the story? Could have? No, I'd like you to explain how it would have changed the story for you. Because this might just be conjecture, but were you making a joke about how white people dance differently than black people? Was that where you were trying to get at? Am I understanding your racist point? Okay, just making sure. I just encourage you, if you're gonna interrupt, at least fucking think it through. So, my point is that sometimes you have to have a sense of humor to deal with ignorance, and I...
And while I was talking about how I was the result of an unplanned pregnancy, the woman chimed in again. Strike three.
I love that my parents didn't plan me. My parents suck at planning. My parents plan to go to Woodstock. What if they plan to have me? Then it started raining. My dad was like, this is going to cause a lot of traffic. Did you just say that and then look around? Seriously, did you just say that? A third time you talked? And you called me nasty?
My glass is empty.
Your glass is empty. Oh, that's weird. Have you emptied your glass? And you emptied your glass. And other people have emptied their glass. And yet they seem to keep their fucking mouth shut.
I don't understand how your glass is magical.
You called what I said nasty. I posit a theory, miss. That... Oh, geez. Who is with her here? You're with her. But you guys also?
We came yesterday. We didn't realize it was on Wednesday.
You came yesterday. So has she been drinking since then?
If that's the only logical explanation for me to be doing a joke about how my dad was silly for not going to Woodstock, and you're like, you're nasty. I would argue it might be nastier to interrupt a show. That's much nastier. So, if you want to try to make a racist joke about my family and then lecture me about how I interact with my parents, maybe you should learn about the definition of nasty. You know, it's interesting because Australia typically is a culture of tall poppy syndrome, where people tend to keep their head down a little bit. That's the culture where people are like, we don't want to stand out too much. So I'm wondering where the fuck you're from. You're right, Dan, they do let any white woman in.
My apologies, Miss Manners. I'll go back to my set. You can leave. That's enough. Yeah, you do it again, you have to go. You understand that now, right? Okay. Is there a little bit left in her glass? Can one of you guys just take that? Because if this is what she's like with a third of a glass left, I don't want that to reach the fucking bottom. Seriously, how fucking, I saw the wine glasses, there's not that much in it. She still has half of the shit left. No, it's because I had wine. No, this is, do not blame alcohol for who you are.
At the Late Show in Atlanta during Jared Berenstein's set, someone was causing a disturbance in the back row.
Sorry, what was that?
No, I'm
lucky. Are you guys okay back there? Are you guys all right?
So you guys need to dip out of here?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yes.
They've been talking and kicking people all night.
Alright, it'd be great if you guys could take off then, if that's the way you guys are going to act, right?
She's also laying across four seats.
She's like asleep?
She's not feeling
good. That's going to be your special
I really appreciate your patience, guys. Can we get some people out of here?
We're not trying to like cause any trouble, man. It's just, please give us some time, okay? She's cool.
Not really. Are you guys gonna be quiet for the rest of the show, or? I mean, it seems like they're disturbing the other guys.
We're not meaning to do that.
Yeah. Is the first warning? Second warning?
First warning.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's the warning.
Sorry to get so dramatic on you guys.
I'm sorry, guys.
Yeah. Do you need a second to get situated, Ben? No? Alright, I'll just start doing jokes.
Woo! Okay. Alright, we got this!
No, don't worry about it, man. I understand. Happens to business. Alright, so, what's his name? Very scared of women growing up. Terrified. Yeah, sex ed. Alright, I know my jokes! I don't need every single word. I'm like, line, scared of women, sex ed. Oh, God, I knew it was in there somewhere.
Her friend left the show to talk to Brett, Drock, and I outside to explain the situation. He basically explained that she meant well, but she was on some medication that didn't mix well with alcohol, and, well, here we are. Now, while he was outside talking to us, it happened again in the showroom.
And I was like, that's weird. How come we're not... Are you all right?
No.
No? Is it still her?
It's still her.
I'm sorry, guys. We gotta get rid of her, man. I'm so sorry about that. Yeah.
All right.
I apologize, everybody. Sorry about this.
Sorry, guys. Have a good night.
That's
okay?
Totally all right, man. Thank you so much for coming.
Have a good night.
Take care. And I appreciate your patience, guys. I cannot throw stones. I have ruined better shows than this.
Sorry, we love you, Jared.
So this is how Brett Drock started his set.
Thank you. Thanks. I'm also the world's least hands-on bouncer. Some of my work I will watch somebody else escort. I'll stand there like I am going to do something. Listen, if she had charged, I was ready. It's nice to be here. You guys seem like a great crowd. You get out of here. See? I'm so good. Touch him. I'm glad you guys are here. Out live comedy. Great. Too many people. Come back in.
Someone else started being super enthusiastic.
I match with a woman on the map. Oh, God. Is there a bad guy in an arcade game in here? I feel like I'm playing the Simpsons game. Oh, shit! Ow.
And then?
Just reached the final stage.
And then.
Started back at round one. Somebody stop putting quarters in that, man.
And one more.
I've never had an audience member react the way way that somebody would to my jokes as if I was beating the shit out of them. I just keep bringing out new weapons. Such a thing is done. Thing wrapped in like barbed wire, and like, oh fuck!
During the Q&A, things got even weirder.
What's your safe word?
What's my safe word? Don't stop, which is probably stupid. Are you two together?
No.
No. Siblings. Okay. Well, this is weird.
We're in the South.
It's no, yeah, this is. We're in Atlanta, not Georgia. So. I don't know if I have a safe word. What is your safe word?
Lineup.
You don't have one. Oh, you're like auditioning for a safe word. What do you got?
Last person that just asked you a question, Rachel or the ass man?
Are you saying fuck, marry, kill?
Yeah, fuck, marry, kill.
Okay, fuck, marry, kill. The person who's sitting in front of me, putting her into a fuck, marry, kill?
Rachel and the Ass Man.
No, I know who Rachel and the Ass Man are. Yeah. These are people from my videos. If you're not familiar with my material, if he doesn't know the Air Canada stuff, he definitely doesn't know the Ass Man. That's from way back. I was performing at a college, and some kid told me that he is known there as the Ass Man. And I was like, why? And I don't want to know why. You know? And then I played that same college a couple years later, and he came again. He came again. Yeah! This is gonna be weird.
Kinda why I asked the question.
Kinda why you asked the question. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you. I'm not gonna fuck Rachel.
You always say there's a right answer to these questions.
I know. I always say there's a right answer to a fuck, marry, and kill, but I never had to do it in front of the person. I don't want to fuck Rachel or the Ass Man.
Oh, no!
So, nice to meet you.
Oh, no!
So I guess I should ask again, what's your safe word? And after that, the other two answers don't fucking matter. All right. I'm sorry, brother. I'm sorry. Are you older or younger?
Younger.
Younger. Okay, then it's not as bad.
Damn.
You were older, you would kick my ass for sure. That's my little sister. But you're younger, you're like, go on, get some, girl, go on. Alright, and I'll take the question that you thought I was pointing to you before.
Oh,
what were you saying?
I was asking about your openers. Can they do a Q&A?
Can they do a Q&A?
Yeah.
No.
On another show.
Brick.
This is my fucking show.
Can I ask a question of Brett?
Can you ask a question of Brett?
Yeah.
Brett, are you here? Yeah.
Brett Truck!
Brett, you want to come out and do part of a Q&A?
Bracelets!
Brett!
This is...
We love Brett!
Can you just stand here for a second?
I want can I pass the question to somebody else? No,
you just made me bring Brett in here. What's your question for Brett?
I was a mile away.
Right.
He was at a Waffle House.
You did that, asshole.
What was your question?
Now that you're gonna put me on the spot,
now I'm gonna say. Brett's on the spot now. What's the question?
My question now he's gonna put me on the spot.
Just answer the question.
I'm gonna ask the question. Brett, as many tours as I've seen you on with him and Andrew Rivers and Danny Jolas, what is your favorite tour?
What's my favorite tour? That's a question for me about him.
You just either one of you guys can answer.
My question is, where's Brett?
Your favorite.
His question is that.
The one that I'm on.
Either one.
That was someone who didn't think things through.
I'm sorry to not mention Jared.
Jared!
I fuck with you, Jared Barrison.
Of all the tours that Brett did, what was your favorite?
Was it the one that you weren't on?
You guys open for Cats? That was amazing. Yeah. That was fucking weird. This
isn't most of them.
Hold on a second. Let's just recap for a moment. Because that wasn't the top two weirdest things. No, we had someone passed out that had to be not dragged out by Brett. And then you had to ask me if I want to fuck her in front of her brother. That was the third weirdest thing.
On this tour, most ridiculous experience.
The fight? What about the fight? The fight was...
Oh yeah, the fight.
The fight. You guys are like, just like the fight didn't spring to mind immediately. It's been a long fucking trip. Right? But yeah, that was the push. A guy, a big fan.
So it was in Nottingham. Oh no, it was
Northampton.
No, Nottingham was ridiculous just because it's a city that is pretending that Robin Hood is a documentary for their tourism. Like, they basically everything. I was staying on the corner of Friar Way and Maid Marian Street. I was like, you're fucking kidding me, right? But Northampton was weirder.
It was a good show.
It was a great show. Amazing it was show. Without this incident, it would have been the best show of the trip.
Yeah.
You guys could still take over if you buy a lot of merch. So there was a guy like kind of off in the far corner. And he was, this guy probably mid-20s, and he's on a date, and he's really focused on the date and not the show. And I can see that he's kind of trying to chatter up a little bit, but he's not loud enough that we can hear, so we don't do anything about it. We're just like, all right, they're not paying attention, fine, whatever. But the guy sitting right in front of him is a big fan, like, had a Steve Austin shirt and everything. And which, by the way, I'm a little disappointed in a lot of you. And so, especially with how far your currency would go to buy. So... He gets eventually, like during my set, he just goes, Steve, I'm very sorry I have to do this. And he turned, because he's British, so he had to like apologize to me before he was doing this. I know that would make him Canadian, actually. And so, so he turns to the guy and he's like, you have to shut up. You're talking through the whole damn show. I've been waiting 3 years to see him. You have to stop.
But the reason I like being a mistake, and I hope that you do too, is because we get the credit.
Sorry, Steve. Can you please shut the fuck up? I've waited 3 years to see this guy, and this crowd has, and all I'm hearing is you two. Please, either enjoy the show, or please go. I've waited 3 years for this guy, and I love this guy. It's a bit so damn to bring it, so please, enjoy the show. Woo!
That was, wait, hold on. We got it from here. I appreciate that. Okay, wait, hold on a second. This is getting very tense right now. And then he turns back, like everything's gonna be fine. And it was not fine, because then that other guy starts talking. I have to kind of like mediate a little bit.
Here's the thing. I can't hear you from here, but I have seen you guys chatty. So if they're freaking out, maybe you are. And if you're not, it won't be a big deal. If you're already being quiet, then it's no big deal and it'll stay the same. Okay, hold on a sec. We're not gonna escalate it. Okay, so it's just if you were just being quiet, then you'll just stay quiet and it won't be a big deal. Okay?
We're enjoying it.
Okay, I appreciate that. Okay. Thank you. Okay, guys, here, wait. This is gonna be weird, but.
And I realized I was like, okay, the only way to do this, and I just turn to him and his wife, and I go,
can I ask you to slide over for a sec? You guys want to come over, sit over here? Would that help a little bit?
Yeah.
All right, cool. This is a first. I did teach briefly, and I just feel like something's going on. I don't know who's right, but I'm separating you. I appreciate it. I don't know who's right, but at the very least, this might balance out the room a little bit. So, alright. Alright. I think I was talking about mistakes. Alright. So you two, I was talking to you two. For a moment when you started speaking up, I thought you were gonna be like, I should have said something earlier, I am also mistaken, I feel horrible.
And so, everything was fine.
Well, for two things. First of all, my apologies for interrupting Steve.
That's okay. That was, we figured it out.
Of course, the guy's been waiting 3 years has a question. He's like, fuck, I've been journaling about this.
If you didn't have a question, I'd be a little hurt, honestly.
You should be.
Yeah, you guys are wearing my shirts.
Oh, is that you?
That's the fucking Canada shirt, and that's the one that says Steve Officer. And I see you're wearing the tour shirt. Which I very much appreciate, and yet it took like 10 minutes of the Q&A for them to be like, alright, now's the time. This is about my ex-wife now, I'm gonna fucking murder you. Okay.
That is a sandwich-based question, dude.
Sandwich-based question.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
Where they have a policy about open sandwiches.
They have a policy about open sandwiches.
I wonder what your thoughts are on the sandwich. No,
all right, let's
fill me in here.
He's an American. He doesn't know where Copenhagen is. Okay. Like, he thinks it's an ice cream chain. Do you guys have that? All right, good. I was wondering if that joke was Australia only. But fucking, I love this cunt so much. What was I going to say? Copenhagen, what is Copenhagen's open sandwich policy? Did you vote to remain or leave? Because... Pardon? You haven't voted yet. Oh fuck, thank God they waited for you.
They gave me enough time, that's wonderful.
I just want to hear about the sandwiches, I want to experience them personally. Yeah.
So, Copenhagen, is there a rule that you can't have an open sandwich?
No, it's an open sandwich, so... Is that a sandwich or not?
So, you're saying that they're traditional sandwich. I thought you were saying it was a law on the street, like in the States, you can't have open container. Like, you can't have, like, an open, like, beer. And in Copenhagen, they're like, drink all you want, but these sandwiches have to stay inside.
Strong attempt at a Danish accent. Love that. Love that energy.
Came as close as possible.
Yeah.
So wait, anyone want to hear? We'll go back to this. You want to hear Dan's American accent?
Let's not do this.
Me all fucking week.
What? Do we have to do the background of the character?
No, just do the accent.
No, we're gonna do the background.
Alright.
So the background, the guy's name is Dick Johnson.
Middle name Peter.
Middle name Peter. And he's always trying to learn a foreign language via a headset. That's his whole thing. So you see Dick Johnson walking around and he's like, bueno. Bueno, bonas dias. Bonjour. I am trilingual, Dick Johnson.
It's a pretty good accent, actually.
I caught that. Amazing.
Applause. Dick Johnson just did better with that side of the room than you did.
Cowards.
All right. Who? Sandwiches.
Sandwich? Do we care?
So is it a sandwich if it's not closed?
What's your thought?
No, it's sandwich ingredients.
Is this like an abortion metaphor? Like, I don't understand. It was like Seinfeld, like, is it a pizza when it goes in the oven or comes out of the oven? Like, I don't know what you're talking about. Like, are you saying, is it a bun if there's no bun on top of the other bun?
So it's two pieces.
An open sandwich is a sandwich.
It's sandwich ingredients. It's not a sandwich until you fully make a sandwich.
What? No, that's, what are you fucking crazy? Like, of course it's a sandwich. Of course, listen, you choose how you eat it.
If someone just gave you half of it without the other half, what would that be?
Well, that'd be half a sandwich. Where's the other half of my fucking sandwich? I want to close this thing off. like their borders. All right. Something I know something about.
I already told them what I said in Belfast. So, who else has a question? We have time for a couple more. You guys have been awesome. Unless we
go one in the back. Wait a minute.
Yeah. When are you going to post the bulletin?
Nicely done.
Man, fucking the crowd does callbacks. I like that. That's awesome. See, that's about as easy as it is to start doing comedy.
That's nice. A crowd that does callbacks and heckles itself. So that's great.
Yeah, wasn't that amazing? That would never happen. Would that happen in the States? Like a crowd member just being like, sorry, Steve, excuse me, I'm so sorry. Shut the fuck up! Like, it was amazing.
No, in the States it would just be a fight. That's all it would be. Or a woman named Karen asking to speak to the manager.
So that was Karen. Excuse me, where's the other half of my sandwich? That was Karen. That was,
I distinctly ordered a sandwich, and then her date, Dick Johnson, steps in.
This isn't a sandwich, this is sandwich ingredients. I love freedom.
Who else? Did anyone else have a question? What do you got there?
Have you been to Greg's yet, Steve?
Have I been to Greg's yet?
Oh, I tried! I tried to take you to Edinburgh!
So, he tried to take me to Edinburgh, but I had heard of Greg's. And Greg's in the States, there's a coffee chain named Greg's with just two G's. I mean, total. Greg's has two G's at the end. Yours has three G's. Which is funny to do to people, by the way. One of my favorite things to do is to tell someone that the word gullible is spelled with three L's. Like, gullible is not. Like, yes, it is. It's not Marat.
The show ended, it was great, and then
it was like an hour. There was like an hour between that and the end of the show, and then like he goes off to sell merch. I don't know if you know, but Steve has merch. Can we mention that more? So he goes off to do that, and I'm just like on stage, kind of like just like looking around, seeing if anyone thinks my tracksuit's cool. And then you just kind of see this commotion, and the guy sitting on the corner is like, come up in front of the guy, and like there's like a 30-year age gap, 25.
Yeah, the guy who asked him to be quiet was probably in his 50s. And this guy, so we all of a sudden we hear glasses break and tables start moving out of the way. This guy is charging for him and takes a swing.
Yeah.
Fucking hits the guy.
Yeah, he like half caught him and he was just like, don't ever fucking say that shit about me, bro. Don't ever say that. Like,
which, by the way, great way to impress your date. If you're ever looking to impress your date, act like a child. They're really into that.
Yeah, beat up someone who's your dad's age in front of her.
Yeah.
I mean, like, I am the alpha male, right? Like, that's the way to do it.
Be like, I always wanted to do this to my dad, but he left when I was young and I couldn't. Like that kind of.
What I'm saying is, I'm ready to be a father.
Yeah.
For some reason I'm involved. Like, I don't know if you can tell, I'm not ready to settle any disputes. Like, that's not my energy. But I'm there gonna be like, hey, go get off him. And this other guy looks like a werewolf. The guy looks like a werewolf.
To the fans' credit, 8 different people descended on this guy. It was cool. My camera was still rolling. I got to watch the whole thing later. So, 8 different people, and you might as well, depending on if it's needed in court. But 8 different people, 8 different people descend on this guy and like just peel him off. He tries to take a swing at another one and misses.
Yeah, and then the guy, there's this guy at the front, he like kind of like a werewolf, but like an old werewolf. You know, like he'd already been a werewolf, and now he was just trying to drive a bus for a living. You know?
He's tired of being a werewolf. He's like, I've seen too much.
I've seen too many moons, just chilling out. Puts him in a fucking headlock, takes him down like MMA shit. And I'm like, this is wild. Like, I don't think werewolves could do anything when the moon is on out, you know? And then like he kind of gets him in a headlock, pushes him out the door. And my favorite bit of the whole thing was like it was from Leicester. I don't know if you know anything about Leicester in England, but this was the comment at the end. He's like, mate, you know, pretty good night, but when that fight happened, fucking great night. But he came in the show the next night.
Yeah.
The guy who got punched, not the guy who punched the guy. It's like, I fucking want round two. Like, yeah. No, yeah, he came to the show the next night. It was very happy.
Yeah, yeah, came down to London, sweet guy.
Yeah, but he asked me to punch him, and I was like, oh man, I'm professional.
Yeah.
And I gave him a quick little karate chop.
Yeah, and the couple, they got married. That's the epilogue.
Yeah, Steve was the celebrant.
Yeah,
and after the ceremony, he sold merch. You know he's got merch?
That is literally how I broke the tension in the room, though, actually. When, this is 100% true, everybody's kind of like, after it gets peeled, like he gets peeled off and the guy leaves and everybody's just kind of standing like, what the fuck just happened? I just said, so does anyone want books or albums or anything? It got a laugh and then it went back to normal, so.
That's a bit of a
highlight of the tour, I think.
Yeah, I love that I had to, for a second, I was like, was that the, oh yeah, the horrible fight that we had.
And then I told a friend of mine from back in the States, I told her the whole story, and she was like, oh my God, but did the cops come? And I was like, the cops weren't called. And she's like, why not? I was like, because it's England.
If you like this, subscribe to my YouTube channel here. Check out my live streams here, or you can watch more videos. If you want to check out my stuff before anybody else, check out patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter. And I just announced next year's tour in over 100 cities. Save a few bucks by getting the presale tickets at stevehofstetter.com.